Hi, this is Jaya. In this video, we shall see the summary of The King and the Queen by Rabindranath Tagore. Since many of you have asked me for the original text, I have downloaded it, and as I am telling you the story, I'll scroll it. You can either take a screenshot or just give a reading to the original text. Now come, let's go to the summary. This is a two-act play by Rabindranath Tagore, and in the first act, we find that King Vikram and Queen Sumitra are in the palace garden, and from their speech we understand that the king is so very much in love with his queen and he wants to spend all his time only with the queen. But whereas the queen understands that the king is spending all his time with her, and she wants him to concentrate on his subjects, that is on the people also, and she finds that his love for her is preventing him from spending time in his duties. So she tells him to concentrate on the people, but the king does not listen, and he says that he is not happy with the way she is showing her love towards him, and he wants her to also exhibit her love like how he is openly showing his love towards her. But Sumitra feels that they should be like father and mother to the children, and they should only give more importance to the people than to their love. And as they are talking, one attendant comes and he says that the minister wants to meet the king. The king refuses, but Sumitra says, no, allow him inside. And the king says, no, if he comes means he is going to tell something about the state, and I am not prepared to do anything, I only want to be with you. But Sumitra says, no, I don't want to stop you from doing your duties, so let the minister come. But before the minister could come inside, the king's Brahmin friend Devadatta, he comes there. And the king actually, when Sumitra tells him to listen to the minister, he gets disappointed and he leaves. So Sumitra is alone, and she asks him, she asks Devadatta, I can hear some noise outside the gate, what is the noise? At that time Devadatta says, shall I go and send those people away? Because they are making noise. But she says, no, I want to know why they are making noise. For that Devadatta says, they are making noise because they are suffering in poverty. They are already used to having very less food, but they are not used to it. They are hungry, and that is why they are suffering. That time she says, why, what happened? Are they not getting enough? But he says, no, they are only getting half a meal a day. And even then, they are not practiced. Though they are getting only half a meal a day so many years, they are not used to it, that starvation, so they are suffering. And Sumitra is surprised. She says, I can get the smell of the ripe corn, so it is harvest time. And how can you say that during the harvest time, the people are suffering of hunger? That time Devadatta says, yes, the land is ready, the harvest is also full. But the thing is, the harvest will not go to these poor people. There are many people who are using the king's name, and they are taking out everything, and only what is being dropped will go to these poor people. And she says, what do you mean? Is there no one to take care of them? Means he says, there are so many people to take care, but they are all in the name of the king, and they are having the power in their hand. And what they do is, they take away everything from these poor people. And these poor people are not able to do anything because they are representing the king. And then Sumitra asks, who are these people who are doing this? And Devadatta says, these people are the ones who came from an alien land. And because they are related to, through the queen to the king, they are using their power and they are robbing the people. And Sumitra is surprised. She says, if you are saying that they are coming from an alien land, because Sumitra is also from an alien land, she is from Kashmir. So she asks, are those my relatives who are robbing the people? And Devadatta says, yes, queen, it is your people. That time she asks, what happens to Jaisen? Jaisen is one of her relatives, and Devadatta says that Jaisen is ruling Singar, and he is taking away everything, nothing is left, and the people are only with skins and bones are there. And then she asks, what about Sheela? Sheela is another relative of Sumitra, and he says, Sheela keeps all his eyes on the trades, and whatever money these merchants are making with through hard work, everything he is taking off, and only the merchants are working very hard, but they are not getting anything. Then she asks about another relative, who is Ajit, and Devadatta says, he lives in Vijayakota and is a very sweet person, he will talk very sweetly, but he will take away everything on which he can keep his hands on. Then Sumitra says, then we should not allow these people who are robbing the citizens of this land to live here. We have to send them away. They should, it can be my relatives, but if they are not good, they should go away from here. And she says, I am going to tell the king to chase them away from this place. At that time, the king comes and she says, save the people. And Vikram says, what you want me to do means, she says, send them out because they are coming here and they are robbing the land. That time Vikram says, you know who are these people? They are all your cousins. And Sumitra says, they can be my cousins, but they are robbers and they are robbing this land. So you have to chase them from this land. That time King Vikram says, see, we cannot just chase them. They will definitely fight. And if we want to send them out, means we also have to fight. And Sumitra says, okay, fight. You have to fight with them. And if you want to save your people, you have to chase these enemies out. That time the king says, first I am not able to conquer you itself. Where I am going to conquer my enemies? That time the king, the queen says, please, you have to take care of your people. And if you don't take care of your people, I will take care of them. And she goes off from here. And Vikram says that she is not able to understand my love for her at all. And then he looks at Devadatta and he says, why have you come here? Did you tell her anything unnecessary? And Devadatta says, no. She heard the shouting from outside and she asked me and I only informed her. And he says, please do not think I am coming here to spoil your happiness. I came here only to get my Brahmin duties because my wife is shouting in the house. There is nothing in my house and there are many people with empty stomach in my house. For that only I came. And he goes to the queen to receive his Brahmin aids. And that time Vikram says that everyone is trying to make others suffer. And at that time the minister comes and the king says, ask all these people who came from the foreign country to go away from my place. Because I must not hear any more cries of hunger in my place. But the minister says, see, this has been happening here for so long time. And suddenly we cannot remove it in one day. But King Vikram says, even a 100-year-old tree can be cut with an axe in one day. So even if we want means, we can remove these people in one day. For that the minister says, then we have to go for the war. And Vikram says, okay, where is my general? Ask him to go for the war. That time the minister says, even the general is a foreigner. That is, Vikram had appointed all his wives, relatives as officers. And then Vikram says, okay, if we cannot fight with these people who have come from alien land, do one thing, open my treasure and give whatever these people want. I don't want them to suffer. I don't want them to cry of hunger. And I only want to be peaceful and I want to be happy. Let them take even my kingdom if they want. I'm not interested in anything. Just ask them to be peaceful and allow me also to be happy. And the minister goes and Sumitra and Devadatta come. And the minister wishes the queen. And Sumitra asks, how are you allowing all this misery to happen in our country? And the minister says, what do you want me to do? You tell me, I'll do it. Then Sumitra says, tell everyone to come and meet me. And the minister says, I already asked them to come. And in fact, I asked them to come in the name of the king. And I didn't ask the king also for permission because I know if I'm going to ask the king, he will not give me permission. And Sumitra asks, when did you ask them to come and meet the king here? And the minister says, I asked them to come and meet the king 1 month back. And so far, I've not got any response. And I don't think they're going to respond hereafter. And Sumitra is surprised. What is this? They will not come even if the king is going to call them. And that time the Devadatta says, the name of the king has become nothing to them. So I don't think they'll get scared of the name of the king because now they become so powerful. And that time Sumitra says, keep all your soldiers ready. And definitely these people are my relatives and they came into this land only using my name. So they have to answer me. And the minister goes off and then Devadatta tells to the queen, queen, they will not come. Even if the king is going to call them, they will not come. That time Sumitra will say, says that then the king will fight with them. And Devadatta says, no, the king will also not fight with them. And that time Sumitra says, if the king does not fight with them, I will fight with them and I will chase them from here. And Devadatta asks, how will you fight with them? That time she says, I will go to my brother Kumarasan, who is the Kashmir's king. And I will ask him to help me to fight these rebels because they have brought disgrace to Kashmir, so he has to help me. And then she asks Devadatta to help her to escape from this kingdom so that she can do some help to the people. And Devadatta salutes her and says he will do whatever he can. At that time King Vikram comes and asks the queen, where are you going? I am coming here to see you and you are going somewhere. That time Sumitra says, I am feeling ashamed that I am sharing all your love. Your love must be for the people only. But it is only for me and I am feeling very bad. And she says, it is okay even if you forget me, even if you hate me. But thing is, I don't want to make my women charm for you to forget that you are a man and that you have to take care of your people. And Vikram feels very bad. And he says that you're not at all understanding my love for you. But Sumitra says, see, I'm prepared even to fall in your feet. But thing is, I don't want to be blamed that you did not do your duty properly. And as they are talking, they hear a voice from outside and they are calling the queen. And Sumitra says it is Devadatta and she calls him inside. And Devadatta says that you have asked the people to come and meet you. But now what has happened is they all have joined together and they are ready for a rebellion. And then Sumitra tells to the king, did you see you heard what he said? You thought that they are my relatives and you spared them. But now they have all joined together against you. And Vikram shouts at Devadatta saying, see, this is not the council house, this is a palace garden. You should not be bringing state matters here. But Devadatta says, you are not at all coming to the council house. How can I inform you all this? That is why I have brought this matter here. Maybe if the council house is also a palace garden where your queen is there, maybe you will be coming there. And then Sumitra says that these people who have come from the foreign land have become miserable dogs. And now they are going against their master itself. And then she tells the king, see, this is not the time to discuss whether you have to talk about this in the council house or in the garden. Thing is, you have to crush these rebels. Only then you can save your people. At that time Vikram says, see, I have to crush these people means I have to send an army. But the general of the army itself is a foreigner. How will he fight with his own people? That time Sumitra says, then you go and fight with the rebels. And Vikram is shocked. He says that you are not understanding my love. Only thing is you are bothered about the people. You are loving others more than me. And now you want me to go and fight leaving you. And that time Sumitra says, yes, now this has become an unfortunate land because the king does not want to take care of his people. And when I am the queen of this people, I have become an unfortunate woman. And she starts going and he asks, where are you going? Means Sumitra says, I am going to leave you because still I am here. You will not do your duty. So I am going to take my farewell from you and I am going to leave you. But Vikram does not believe her. Sumitra says, if I am going to be by your side, I am going to make you more and more weak, which I don't want to do. And she goes off. And Devadatta saying, are you going to allow her to go alone? Means the king says, no, she will not go. But Devadatta says, no, I think she is very serious when she is saying this. So please don't allow her to go alone. And that time the king says, no, women are like that only. And many times she has defied me like this. But thing is, she can't escape from my love. She'll be only here. And he says to Devadatta, why are you bringing all this information into my house? It is like you're putting snake in my nest. At that time, Devadatta says, no. Now your house is in fire. I only brought the news to you to wake you up. And please don't blame me for anything. And that time the king says, see, I'm very happy. I only want to be happy. I don't want anything to disturb my happiness. And please don't spoil it. At that time, a courtier comes. And this courtier is also a foreigner. And he says, I came here to ask justice from you. Actually, we have come from the Queensland and we are staying here. But thing is, we heard that false accusations have been informed to you about us. And we don't want you to treat us badly because we are foreigners. But Vikram says, see, I don't know whether what you're saying is true or not. How can I trust you? Until I trusted you, I remained quietly. But thing is, you people have started insulting me, which I cannot allow. And another thing is, you have started even misusing the powers which I gave you. Even that I cannot allow. So just be quiet and don't try to rob my people. If you're going to rob my people, means I'll definitely take actions against you. And the courtier leaves after that. At that time, the minister and Devadatta, they enter and they say that the queen has left the palace riding a horse. And the minister tells him that is very sure it was the queen who went and they were not able to stop because she went in secret. And the king asks, who gave you the news that the queen has left? And the minister says, the priest only told me that the queen has left because he saw her riding before the palace temple. And then the king asks the minister to bring the priest, and he says, I want to know whether what he saw is the truth. That time the minister says, no, I am very sure. But at the same time he says, she has left only now. If we send our soldiers, definitely we can bring her back. And that time Vikram says, no, I don't want that. The thing is, she has left me. That is what matters more. And second thing is, now the news is going to spread that the queen has left. And the people have a poisonous tongue and they will be saying anything. And that time Devadatta says, yes, to save the people, the queen has spoiled her own name. And Vikram says, go and bring the priest. I want to ask him the details. And at that time, the minister goes and he brings the priest. And the king asks the priest whether he saw the queen only riding in the horse, and the priest confirms it. And at that time the king asks whether there were tears in eyes when she left, and the priest says, I was not able to see because she came only for a moment. She checked the horse and she started riding the horse and she went out, and the face also was changed, turned the other way. So I don't know whether tears were there in her eyes. And then Vikram says, okay, you can go. And then when the minister says, shall I go and bring her back? He says, no. She has left me and I know how to bring her back. And so I don't want you to go now and bring her here. I will definitely crush the rebellions who are here. And also I know how to bring her back. And then he talks to Devadatta. Actually, Devadatta is a childhood friend of the king. And he says that, why is that these people don't understand me at all? And Devadatta says, I can understand you. And at the same time, I want you also to perform the duties what you have to perform. And Vikram says, okay, but thing is, I am deeply hurt that my queen has left me, and I want her to love me and I want her to be with me, and I know what I have to do for that. At that time an attendant comes and he hands over a letter saying that it is from the queen. And at first Vikram thinks that she regrets leaving him, but after reading the letter he understands that she has written only two lines saying that she is going to her brother in Kashmir and she is going to ask him for help to come and crush the rebellions in his kingdom. And he says, this is an insult. How can people from Kashmir come and help me here? It shows that it's a disgrace for me. And Devadatta says, see, don't lose your time. Go and bring her. And bringing her back only is like taking your revenge on her. But Vikram says, I know how to take my revenge on her. And the first act ends there. And in the second act, we find that the king and his generals are in a tent in Kashmir, and from their talk we understand that they have crushed the rebellions in their place, and the rebellions have now joined with the king, and they have come here to Kashmir and they have crushed the full army of Kashmir, that is Kumar Sen's army. And Kumar Sen is hiding in the in a place in a mountain, and the people are searching for him so that he will surrender. And the general says that we are spending a lot of time here because the people love Kumar Sen so much that they are protecting him. And now our place needs us. We have to go there. People are asking us to come there. But Vikram says, see, the fight is not yet over. The fight will get over only when Kumar Sen surrenders or when we capture him. And he has to get the punishment for his sister's behavior. And then the general informs that his uncle, that is Kumar Sen's uncle Chandra Sen, he wants to become the queen, king now. And he wants the king to, that is King Vikram, to make Chandra Sen the king of Kashmir. And he wants the king to leave that place also, because now after the war, there is so much of things to be settled down there. But Vikram says, see, I am not staying here to give punishment or anything to anyone. Only thing is, I have come here to take my revenge. I am waiting for him to surrender, and only when he surrenders the fight will be over. And I want my wife also to come and say sorry to me, and that is why I am waiting here. And that time the general goes, and what happens is another general comes and he says that a carriage has come towards the tent, and I think he says that they are coming to ask for peace. But Vikram says, after a war there will be peace, but that war is not yet over. So definitely there cannot be any peace. At that time a soldier enters and he says that the queen has come to ask to meet the king. But Vikram says, you cannot allow the queen inside. And Vikram knows that this is the third time that she is coming, but each time she comes, Vikram has refused to meet her, and he wants to capture Kumar Sen. And in order, the way he is going to capture him only will be the punishment for her for leaving him. And also the war came after that, and everything came only after she has left him. So he wants her to understand how much he loved her, but she did not understand his love. And even the generals all say, sir, when the queen is coming to meet you, we are you are asking us to stop her from meeting, and that is, we are finding it very difficult. But Vikram says, see, you only have to do your duty, and this is not the place for me to meet any women. So you just keep a watch on the door and don't allow anyone inside. At that time, Shankar enters, and this Shankar is Kumar Sen's servant, and he is an old man. And he says, see, you're keeping me as a captive in your tent. And he says, your queen is also waiting outside your tent. And this is not the way you have to behave with her. You have to pardon. And the queen understands that all this is only because of her leaving you. And she says that I will take the full blame. And she wants you to spare her brother and her brother's country. That is why she has come here to meet you. That time Vikram says, see, you are an old man. And you will understand that once a war is begun, we will not stop it, because it is a man's pride. We will carry it till the end. And it is the main reason for this war is this women. That also everyone knows. And he says that let her suffer some more. I want her to suffer little more. And then afterwards Shankar says, see, I know about our king. And he is like a man. He will and you people are you have waged the war for your domestic purpose. And think what has happened. It is not nice. But Vikram says, see, you are an old man, but you are talking, that is why you are taking the advantage of talking all this to me. But thing is, I want Kumar Sen, who fought with me for the sake of his sister, to surrender. And only if he surrenders, I will think about pardoning him, and all that will be discussed only later on. But Shankar says, I know my king very well. You cannot expect him to surrender as far as he is alive. And his sister also will not allow him to undergo the shame of surrendering. Because if you surrender means it is only like begging for your life, and my king will not beg for his life. And Vikram says, see, then the war will continue till he surrenders or till I capture him. And Shankar says, you cannot capture him, because you may have surrendered and maybe you are nearing him, but my king knows how to escape. And when Vikram asks, what do you mean, means Shankar says, my king will rather die than surrender himself or get captured by you. At that time, an attendant comes and he says that Chandrasen, that is Kumar Sen's uncle, and Revati, Kumar Sen's aunt, they have come to meet the king. And Vikram asks them to come, and they say that we have come here. And Chandrasen asks, what punishment have you decided for Vikram? And for Kumar Sen. And Vikram says that if he surrenders means I'll pardon him. At that time Revati says, see, you have done some, so a war is gone, and war is not a child's play. And if one person is going to surrender, will you pardon him? How can you pardon him? You have to give him punishment. That time King Vikram says, see, I did not come to rob here. I only came here for my honor. And I know that another king, that is a person who is wearing the crown, he should not be insulted. So I don't want to insult him. At that time Chandrasen says, see, I just want you to forgive him. But at the same time, we know that Chandrasen wants to become the king. So he says, don't give him back the throne. Don't make him the king again. But at the same time, don't kill him. But Vikram says, see, I never came here to kill him, and I never wish to take his life away. But Revati says, why did you kill all the soldiers who had nothing to do with all this? You have killed all the innocent people. And you're going to say, and you're saying you're not interested in taking the life of Kumar Sen. And Vikram says, I'm not able to understand you, what you're trying to say. You want me to punish him, you want me to kill him. Is this the punishment you want me to give it to Kumar Sen? At that time, Chandrasen says, no, she's only angry because because Kumar Sen brought all this trouble to the country. And we are related to him, that is why she's very angry with him. And Revati says, see, we came here only to tell you that we are not hiding him, but the people of this country are hiding him. And so if you go and burn the crops and if you burn the villages, then the people will suffer in hunger, and they themselves will bring him to you. And Chandrasen says, calm down. And he says to the king, we want you to come to our palace and Gray says, and Vikram says, okay, okay, I'll come, and they'll go, and he's thinking about how women can, how women react in different situations, and he is surprised that women can go to that extent also, thinking about Revati's feelings towards Kumarsen. At that time, an attendant comes and he says that the Brahmin Devadatta has come to meet him, but the king says, no, 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 I will not allow him to come inside, because if he meets me, he will only ask me to come back, and I don't want to go back, I want to end this war here. At that time, the Tirchur's chieftain, he comes there, he is Amaru, and he says that I came here to show my respects to you, and he says that you are the king of kings, sir, and I am your servant, and I have brought my daughter Ila. And he says his daughter Ila is a young and a beautiful woman, and he feels that she will be a very good queen to the king. And so he asks him permission whether he can bring here her inside and offer him to the king. And Ila comes inside, and Vikram is surprised on looking at her, and he says that she is a very beautiful girl, and he talks to her. But he finds that her limbs are shivering, and he asks, why are you shivering? That time Ila says that I heard that you are a great king, and I have something to ask you. And Vikram says, okay, okay, ask me whatever you want. I will give you whatever you want, because I'm a person who is capable of giving anything you ask. And that time Ila says, I know my father has brought me here to give me to you, but thing is, I'm asking you not to take me, because you are a very big king, you have everything, so please don't take me. And Vikram says, why do you think that I'm not worthy of you? That time she says, no, 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 if you have to take me means you have to take me like how you hunt a deer. Before hunting the deer, you shoot it with an arrow, and that arrow goes and spears his heart, and then only you take. Like that, if you are going to take me means my life will leave me before I could reach you. That time Vikram says, why are you talking like this to me? Don't you like me? That time she says, no, my heart is not mine. I have given to another person so many months back, and he has promised that he will come back and he will take me with him. And when he comes back, if I am not there, means he will leave me and he will never come back. So I don't want that to happen. That is why I'm asking you, don't take me. And Vikram says, then that person must be a very fortunate person. And who is that person? And he says, don't worry, I will not take you. And Ila says, the person who has taken my heart is the Kashmir's king Kumarsen. And Vikram is surprised, and when he mentions the name Kumarsen, Ila asks whether Vikram knows Kumarsen, and she says that everyone knows him, because he is such a nice person, everyone knows him. And she says that maybe he is your friend. And Vikram says, yes, I know him, but now I know that he is hiding from his enemies, and he is no longer the king, he must be the poorest beggar in this place. And Ila says, I'm not able to understand what you're saying. At that time, Vikram says, see, he is now hiding from his enemies, and his enemies are almost nearing capturing him. So his life is doomed. That time Ila says, why are you saying all this? Tell me the truth. See, like, please, I want to know where he is so that I can go and reach him. I cannot live without him. And if you know where he is, you tell me. That time Vikram says his enemy soldiers are after him, and he is definitely doomed. That much I know. That time Ila says, now you are a king and he is also a king. So a king must help another king. Can't you use your powers and save him? Because I am asking you to do this for my sake. I am a weak woman and I want you to help me. And Vikram, seeing the way she loves Kumarsen, he says, I can understand your love for him. And he says, trust me, I am your friend and I'll definitely bring him to you. And Ila says, if you bring him back to me, I will owe my life to you, and my heaven of happiness will be there in my life. And Vikram says, okay, okay, I can understand how much you love him. Now go and get dressed like a bride, and I will definitely bring him to you, and you can be very happy, and I will get you married to him. At that time, Devadatta comes and he says that people are stopping him, but somehow he escaped. And when the king asks him how he escaped, he says, I recited to them some of the lyrics of Kalidas, and hearing that they had a peaceful sleep, and at that time I came here. And when the king thinks how careless these people are there, he says, please don't think about all that. I only came here to ask you to come back, and I also want to go back to my place because my family is there, so we have to go back. And Vikram says, yes, even I am tired of all this, so I am going to end this war and we will go back to our place. And now it is time, I think we will be capturing Kumarasen, and along with the with Kumarasan, we'll be capturing the queen also. And once I meet the queen, I'll also be very happy. So we will go back happily. And Vikram says, now I want everything to end and all of us should be very happy. At that time, Chandrasen, he comes there and he says, and Vikram tells Chandrasen, see, I have decided to pardon Kumarasen. That time Chandrasen says, okay, you can pardon him. But thing is, now I am the king of Kashmir. And he has brought all the trouble to Kashmir. So, I only have to decide what punishment I have to give him. That time Vikram says, you cannot punish him. Because I only made you the king. But if you are going to use that to punish Kumarasen, I will make Kumarasen only as the king of Kashmir. That time Chandrasen says, you don't know what sort of a person he is. He is a very proud person. This throne came to him through his father. And now, if you are going to say that you are going to give the throne as a gift to him, he will not accept it. Because I know Kumarasen very well. That time a messenger enters and he says that Kumarasen is coming to meet the king in a closed carriage to surrender himself. And Chandrasen, who is the uncle of Kumarasen, is surprised because he cannot imagine that Kumarasen, who is like a lion, is coming to beg for his life to the king. And Vikram wonders why he is coming in a closed carriage. And Chandrasen says maybe he knows that people will look at him shamefully. That is why he is hiding and coming in the dark to surrender himself and beg for his life. At that time, Devadatta comes and he says that, I heard that the king is coming he is coming on his own will to meet you. And Vikram says, I am going to welcome him as a friend. And so he says, ask the priest, you can be the priest because Devadatta is a Brahmin. And we will make the wedding festival here and we will get him married also. And the other Brahmin elders of Kashmir, they come there and they are very happy that the war is over and they have come to bless Vikram. And Vikram is very happy to receive their blessings. And that time Shankar also comes and he says, he asks Chandrasen, is it true that Kumarasen has surrendered and he is coming here to his enemies? And Chandrasen says, yes, it is true. And Shankar is shocked because he cannot expect Kumarasen to come down to that level. And he says that, I cannot believe it. And he says, I want to die before that surrender of Kumarasen happens before him. At that time, a soldier comes and he says, the carriage has come to the door. And Vikram says, play the music, we welcome them as a friend. And when the music is playing, Sumitra enters and she has a tray in her hand and the tray is covered. And when Vikram sees Sumitra, he is very happy. But Sumitra says that, Vikram, he says that you have wasted all the days searching for my brother Kumarasen here and you have neglected your duty and neglected taking care of your people there. So Kumarasen understood what is going to happen, that is you are not going to leave this place till he surrenders. And so what he has done is he will not accept defeat, he will not accept surrender. So what he has done is he has killed himself and he has cut his head and he has given his head to you. You can take this head with you. And Vikram is shocked that Kumarasen has died in honor. And Sumitra says, I am also no more your queen. And she says, death has claimed me also. And she also falls and she dies. And Shankar, who sees this, he says, I understand. He says, what I thought about Kumarasen is true. He will not come down and beg for his life to anyone. And he says, your servant, that is, I am your servant, I will also follow you in honor. And he also dies. And at the same time, Ila, who gets dressed like a bride, comes there and she says, I heard the music and I know it's a bridal music. And she asks, where is my lover? I am ready. And the play ends here. It's a very beautiful play by Rabindranath Tagore. If you have anything more to add on to this, please write it in the comment box. Like the video, share it with your friends. And if you have not subscribed my channel, please subscribe. Thank you.